If there are no wood production objective at all, pro-climate forest owner does nothing. I mean, he or she does not cut forests, because a growing forest remains an effective carbon stock and carbon sink longer than any contemporary forest owner will live. In an outgrowth forest, carbon is also stored in dead wood very effectively. And it is probable that the forest owner who wants to bind carbon also wishes to maintain biodiversity. That is another big environmental problem in Europe, and doing nothing also responds to this problem. And this is, we again regard climate change as a kind of problem that we should respond now. It is not wise to release a considerable part, or more or less considerable part, of the carbon from forest into the atmosphere by cutting the forest, and then wait that the growing forest will add the carbon during the next decades or century. And this release always happens when a forest is cut, even if a part of the biomass would end into long-lasting wood products. Of course, we also need wood biomass to replace fossil materials, but I'm not at all worried about the wood supply for the industry. It's unrealistic to think that all forest owners would stop wood production because of climate change mitigation or other reasons. We also remind again that not every forest owner is most probably interested in to storage or bind carbon in their forests. Then, for a forest owner who aims to balance wood production and climate change mitigation, I would recommend continuous cover management or selective loggings, longer rotation times, and less intensive thinnings. This is what forest science seems to recommend now. And if a clear cutting is practiced, then I recommend considerably longer rotation times.